reports the shelter-in-place order and an air and water restrictions have been lifted. But at this hour, the fire continues to burn in a derailed train car in southwest Jefferson County.
It has been roughly 28 hours since cleanup at the derailment site took an explosive turn near Dixie Highway and Catherine Station. WLKY's Marissa Alter has the latest developments from the command post. Marissa?
Well, Rick, we want to be clear that that evacuation order remains at this hour, but the shelter-in-place order has been lifted, and that's because officials are now calling that fire a controlled burn. Let's go to the WLKY News Chopper for a live look at the scene right now. Now, a controlled burn means they have water going on it to keep the car cool, keep the flames from flaring up. They say this is no longer a danger to nearby derailed cars filled with other chemicals. Now, how long this controlled burn will go, officials just don't know.
Someone referred to it as the eternal flame, and that's probably a good depiction, seems like, based on how long it's going to, it has been burning based on what our estimates originally were.
Now, this situation began yesterday afternoon around 1. Workers were using what P&L now says is called a settling torch to separate two derailed cars. P&L spokesman Gerald Gupton says air monitors told them the air was clear and that it was safe for them to use that torch. Of course, that proved incorrect as residual butadiene vapors were present. Those ignited and sparked a flash fire. Now, 3 workers were rushed to the hospital, and at the last update we had, 1 was in critical condition, 2 in fair condition. There were concerns, obviously, about nearby cars filled with corrosive gas called hydrogen fluoride. That sparked the initial shelter-in-place and evacuation orders, all as a precaution. Officials were first told that that burning car only had a small amount of residual chemical in it, but that proved inaccurate.
We report what people tell us, which isn't always correct and true. I suspect at the time it was based on their best estimates and what I would hope to be the best consultants, but that proved to be incorrect. It doesn't mean it was false, doesn't mean it was a lie, it was incorrect.
Now, obviously, still a lot of questions at this hour about exactly what happened and exactly how long this situation will continue. Of course, what comes next? Well, we know the controlled burn will continue, but the good news about it is that P&L workers will be able to do stuff around that site while that controlled burn is going. We're told that they brought in a new team, these are specialists, to reassess the situation, and that specialized equipment will be brought in soon. Now, they are hoping to begin to offload some of the chemicals that are still present at that site tonight and bringing in some specialized equipment specifically for those risky hydrogen fluoride cars tomorrow. How long this entire situation will continue, we just don't have a timetable on that, but of course we will continue to keep you updated. For now, reporting live from the command post, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.
Thank